friends, and welcome to the Faith and Knitting Podcast. My name is Rhonda, and I am coming to you from our home just outside of Philadelphia, where I live with my family, my husband and my two sons for now. Our daughter is in London studying for the semester, and she'll be home next month, so we're looking forward to that. We miss her very much. So I welcome you. Thank you for joining me. If you're new, thank you for joining. If you are a returning viewer, I thank you so much and I appreciate the fact that you're returning. This is another video in the Water from the Well series on the Faith and Knitting channel. So the Faith and Knitting channel, in case you're new, is a channel where I talk about faith and God and I talk about knitting. But the series of Water from the Well is where I'm focused mainly on the faith part of the podcast. So it's a shorter video, and I just talk about different aspects of faith and what is important to us in our faith. And I hope that you're all doing well. I know things are in our world right now are crazy, and I'm going to talk a little bit more fully about that. I won't do it this time because I'm trying to keep these Water from the Well videos. I like to keep sort of short, but next week I plan to do another full Faith and Knitting episode, where I will talk a little bit more about the things that are going on in our world right now that that are just very devastating and tragic. So I won't do that today, but I will address that briefly next time. So again, welcome. I'm so glad that you joined me. But what I'd like to talk about today is spending time alone with God, about having a time that is separate and set apart and dedicated to focusing on God, where we intentionally meet with him. And I thought I would show you a little view outside the window. This is where I sit in my chair here every morning to do my devotional time, my time alone with God. And so I'll just show you out the window a little bit what it looks like out there. We have a very gray, as you can see, a very gray overcast day today. It looks like it might rain. I don't know. But I thought I'd just show you that. This is where I sit and do my devotional time. Our relationship with God should be the most important relationship of our lives. More even than our spouses or our children, more than our parents, our siblings, our friends. God wants to be number one. He wants to have first place in our hearts, the number one relationship that we have. And as with all relationships, it takes two. Both parties working toward the goal of growing the relationship. And also, as with all relationships, it takes time. Time spent with that person in order to build and deepen and strengthen the relationship. And it's no different in our relationship with God. If we don't dedicate time to it, it's not going to be the strong, solid relationship that we want to have. And as I said, it takes two. It takes both parties. And God has done his part. He has done everything needed for us to have a deep, strong relationship with him. He's made it possible. He's made a way for a fallen, rebellious people to have connection with and communion with a perfect, eternal, flawless God. He's made it possible for us. He's done his part. The door is open on God's side. Is our door open to God? In Revelation 3:20, it says, "I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come into him and eat with him, and he with me." He says, "I stand at the door and knock, and if anyone opens the door, I will come in." We have to open the door. God is not going to kick the door down and force his way into our lives. He's not going to do that. He stands and he knocks. He waits for us to open the door, to invite him in. But notice what he said. He said, if anyone opens the door, anyone, he says, I will come in and eat with that person and they will eat with me. And that eating together is a sign of the friendship and the fellowship that he wants to have with us. He said, if anyone opens the door, anyone, I will come in. Anyone who's willing to open the door, he says, I stand and I knock. And one sure way of opening the door and building a relationship with God is to have that separate, set apart, dedicated time alone with him. The Lord told us, he said, when you pray, go into your room and shut the door and pray to your Father who is in secret. Go into your room and shut the door and pray to your Father. So he is talking about this separate, this set apart time alone with God. And he modeled it for us himself. He often went off to solitary places alone to pray. Prayer services, we can go to prayer services or worship services or church services where we gather with our church families and we worship, we pray, and all of that is good. All of that is needed. All of that we should certainly do. But there is something special and wonderful that happens when we set time aside, where we get alone with God, where we give him our attention, our time, our focus, and we give him ourselves. We try as best as we can to eliminate distractions or interruptions so that we can focus with an undivided mind on him. Someone who was especially adamant about this subject and who wrote profusely about it is Andrew Murray. He was a South African pastor from the 1800s who had a passion for spending time alone with God to the point that it fueled and it shaped his entire ministry. He is one of my favorite authors and teachers. He wrote eloquently and passionately about spending time alone with God. He called it secret prayer, which I love that. I love the sound of that because it makes it sound close and intimate. Spending time in secret prayer with God. He wrote about the importance of it, what it does for us, how it blesses us. And his devotional book that I have it here, and this actually is the devotional book that I've used. I used it last year and I'm going through it again this year. It's a 365-day devotional. It's for, so it takes you through the whole year. It's called Daily in His Presence. And you can see it's a little worn from my second year going through it. It's called Daily in His Presence, a classic devotional from one of the most powerful voices of the 19th century. And the book is divided into themes. Each month is a different theme. So for instance, January, the theme is the secret of adoration. In February, the secret of a new life in Christ. April, the secret of a life of faith. And he calls it the secret because it's a secret prayer that he's talking about. So the secret of fellowship with God in June, the secret of intercession in August. And I remember that one was really good. So I'm looking forward to August so I can read through those devotions again because that was, and it's the whole thing is good. The whole thing is really good. So I want to read you a couple of quotes from his devotional book so that you can see what he says about spending time alone with God. So the first one is, it is when we bow before God, recognizing his majesty and his holiness, his power and his love, and seek to give him the honor and the reverence and the worship that are his due, that our hearts awaken to the nearness of God and the working of his power. His writing is so beautiful and so simple and humble and completely God-focused. And he calls us to consider God and to think of him, to meditate on him in all of his majesty and power, and to be awed by his glory and his holiness to the point that the only response we can have is to worship. And we can do this, I think, most fully and best when we are alone with God, when we spend that time, we take that time free from distractions and busyness, and we slow down and give God some of our time. Spend that time with him, alone with God. This is another quote from Andrew Murray. Alone with God, that is the secret of true prayer, of a living, close intimacy with God and of power for service. Without time spent alone with the Father, there can be no true deep conversion, no growing devotedness to God, no powerful equipping from the Holy Spirit, and no continued peace or joy. Then he continues, let it be the one thing you set your heart upon, to seek, find, and meet with God. That is so good. He's saying that without this time alone with God, we won't have that close, intimate relationship with him that causes us to grow in our devotion, grow in our commitment, grow in our trust in him. We won't have the equipping of the Holy Spirit or the power for service to God, for service for God and service to others. And we won't have the continued increasing peace or joy that should be the mark of every child of God. Time alone with God, this set apart, separate, secret, sacred time spent alone with our Father, it is vital to a deep, close, growing, and fruitful relationship with him. And yes, we have to push past the tendency of our culture to be always, you know, go, 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 do, 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 busy with this, busy with that, so that there's no time to slow down. There's no time to be still and sit with God. We don't have time. We don't have time to stop and sit and spend with God. That it almost feels like a luxury that we can't afford to set apart time to spend with God. We just don't have the time. And we have to resist that urge to be just busy all the time. Because if we haven't connected with God, then what's all the busyness for anyway? I mean, what is it going to accomplish for us? What is it going to produce in our lives if we haven't connected with God? It'll only most likely lead us to stress and irritation and frustration and burnout. And maybe it takes a sacrifice. Maybe we have to spend less time on our phones or watching movies or watching television. Maybe we have to get up earlier to spend that time with God. Whatever it takes, whatever we have to do, it will be worth it. It will be worth it if we can draw near to God and live in his presence and experience his peace throughout the day. So one more quote from Andrew Murray. Let this be the main purpose of your quiet time, to sense the presence of your Heavenly Father. Take time to pray to him. He knows how you long to be in his presence, and he will listen to you. Then follows the great promise. Your Father, who sees what is done in secret, will reward you openly. All through your busy, active day, God will answer your prayer. The prayer said in your sanctuary will be followed by the secret working of God in your heart. The prayer said in your sanctuary will be followed by the secret working of God in your heart. And yes, we do live in a busy day. We do live among the hustle and the bustle. But if we take time to connect with God before we get out into the hustle and the bustle, then that secret time of prayer produces something for us. God will be working in our heart throughout the day, and we'll be more aware of his presence, and it will give us a sense of peace that will carry us through the busyness of our day. Again, let it be the one thing that you set your heart upon to seek, find, and meet with God. It is vital. It is vital to our relationship with God. It is vital to our life as a Christian. It is vital. There is no substitute. There's nothing that we can replace this with, this time alone with God. It is what strengthens us and helps us to live the life that we are supposed to live. And I think I haven't found anyone who speaks about it better or writes about it better than Andrew Murray. And so this is a book that I would recommend, this Daily in His Presence, this devotional book. I have a few other, I have quite a few other books by him, but the one that I would also recommend is this Humility. This book, it's a little small book, but oh my goodness, so much is packed into this book. This is also Andrew Murray. Excellent book. So, so good. I mean, I think this should be recommended reading for every Christian. The other one that is also by Andrew Murray is this one called Absolute Surrender. Another very small book, but he can say so much in a few words that it's tremendous. It's really tremendous. And these are old copies, these old editions. I found these, I think, in secondhand bookstores. But so the newer versions have different covers, but it's Absolute Surrender and Humility. I mean, if we get these two things, if we can live in humility and we can live toward God in absolute surrender, there, and we get this alone with God time down, there's nothing that can beat it. Another book by Andrew Murray, I only have it in Kindle form. It's called The Inner Sanctuary, and it's all about that secret time that we have with God. That is a tremendous book. I don't have my Kindle here, but I can't show you the cover of it. But these two are excellent. The devotional is very good. Excellent, excellent books on this subject. And if Andrew Murray, I think, could be, if you're a new Christian, if you're a new believer, or if you're not a believer and you're just kind of curious about this, I think Andrew Murray is a great choice. He might be a little deep, though. But someone that I just discovered recently is this Dane Ortlund, and he wrote this book, Deeper. And this is about growing deeper with God. And he writes in such a simple way, very profound, but a very simple wording that it's so easy to understand and it's so easy to get. And he has, I think this is his second book, I believe. And this is also, I think this is his first book, Gentle and Lowly. So beautifully written. The subtitle of this one is The Heart of Christ for Sinners and Sufferers. And this book just will melt your heart. It will melt your heart. It's so beautifully written. Dane Ortlund is his name. I'll put the title and link these below in the description box. Because all of these, and these aren't big books either, but, and I have my Bryce Ted, my price sticker still on it. I tried to take it off, but I think it was going to tear and mess up the book. So I spent $15 on this book and I spent $12 on this book. But I don't know what their original prices are. I got them at, that's much less than the original price. I got them at the workshop that I went to a couple weekends ago. But anyway, so these are more simply written than the Andrew Murray books, but just as profound, just as heart-stirring. So I would recommend these, especially if you are a newer Christian or, again, someone who's just wanting to find out more about Christianity. Deeper and Gentle and Lowly. Again, I will link these below in the description box. But spend that time with God. Spend that time with God. Separate, set apart, alone time with God. Because there is nothing that will strengthen you more. Nothing that will grow your faith and your relationship stronger and better than time spent alone with God. So that's all I wanted to share with you for today. I wanted to keep these videos short, the Water from the Well series. I wanted to be short videos. So thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. I'm so grateful. I'm very encouraged by the comments that you leave. I am so appreciative of everyone who watches, everyone who subscribes. Thank you once again. I appreciate it. And again, I am planning to do another faith and knitting video next week. So there I'll share some of my knitting projects, my works in progress that I'm working on. And I have a couple of ideas for new projects. So I'm really excited about sharing with those, sharing those with you as well. So once again, thank you so much. God bless you. And I will be praying for you. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye. Oh.